While life arose and evolved on Earth, Mars experienced serious climate change. Planetary geologists can study rocks, sediments and soils for clues to uncover the history of the surface. Well, the Red Planet is an obvious target for exploration, because it is close by in our solar system, but there are many more reasons to explore it. The scientific reasons for going to Mars can be summarized by the search for life, understanding the surface and the planet's evolution, and preparing for future human exploration. And a shocking new discovery that has emerged from a NASA study says that evidence of ancient life may have been scrubbed from parts of Mars. Orbit. Beyond the blue. The space agency's Curiosity rover made the surprising discovery while investigating clay-rich sedimentary rocks around its landing site in Gale Crater, a former lake that was made when an asteroid struck the Red Planet roughly 3.6 billion years ago. Clay is a good signpost towards evidence of life because it's usually created when rocky minerals weather away and rot after contact with water, which is a key ingredient for life. It is also an excellent material for storing microbial fossils. The rover completed its analysis by drilling into the layers of the Martian rock before using its chemistry and mineralogy instrument, known as CHEMIN, to investigate the samples. The process of chemical transformation in sediments is called diagenesis, and it could have created new life beneath Mars, even as it erased some of the evidence of the old life on its surface. So even though old records of life may have been erased in the brine patches, the chemical conditions brought about by the influx of salty water may have enabled more life to spring up in its place. Curiosity's mission to Mars began 9 years ago, but the rover has continued to study the Red Planet well past its initial 2-year mission timeline, to establish the historic habitability of Mars for life. While Curiosity continues to function well beyond its previously predicted timeline, others have joined it in the task of exploring Mars. InSight, short for Interior Exploration Using Seismic Investigations, Geodesy, and Heat Transport, is a Mars lander designed to give the Red Planet its first thorough checkup since it formed 4.5 billion years ago. It is the first outer space robotic explorer to study in depth the inner space of Mars, its crust, mantle, and core. Studying Mars' interior structure answers key questions about the early formation of rocky planets in our inner solar system, which are Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars, more than 4 billion years ago, as well as rocky exoplanets. InSight also measures tectonic activity and meteorite impacts on Mars today. Since 2018, it has detected over 1,300 Marsquakes, the Martian version of earthquakes, and revolutionized our understanding of the planet's subsurface. This is the first time that InSight, or any Mars lander or rover, has ever detected the seismic waves from a meteoroid impact. So far, InSight has heard the impacts of 4 different space rocks. Scientists call these rocks meteoroids, before they hit the ground. Afterward, as on Earth, the fragments are called meteorites. NASA's Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter took images of the impact sites from orbit. They appeared as dark spots in the orbiter's black and white context camera. Later, the high-resolution imaging science experiment camera, HiRISE, took detailed color photos. The 3-year wait for InSight to finally detect a meteoroid impact was well worth it. The seismic waves generated by the impacts can give scientists clues about both the impacting rocks and the Martian subsurface. As on any rocky planet or moon, scientists can use impact craters to determine the age of the surface. Basically, it's fairly simple: the more craters there are, the older the surface is. Then, researchers can compare the rate of impacts in the past to the rate of impacts today. Not only do impacts reveal clues about the planet, but also about the impact events themselves. By using both InSight's data and orbital images of the impact craters, researchers can determine the meteoroid's trajectory and size of its shockwave, that is, seismic wave. Even though Mars's atmosphere is extremely thin, the meteoroids create shock waves as they hit it, and explosions when they hit the ground. You can hear it right now. Pretty cool, right? We are living in an era like none other. Webb is unfolding the universe like never before. We have smashed a spacecraft into an asteroid, and we can now hear meteoroid impacts on Mars. To me, it feels like we are living in a truly science fiction era. Unfortunately, InSight's mission is likely coming to an end soon. InSight uses solar panels for power, and accumulating dust means that it will run out of power by the end of this year or early next year. But, at the same time, we are also studying and searching for life on other planets close to us. One such planet, or rather dwarf planet, is the ex-solar system member, Pluto. Imagine you're a part of a group chat with your best mates. Your closest friends who you thought loved and accepted you for who you are. Then one fine day, without any warning or intimation, they remove you from their group, for some reason that's beyond your control. Soon, you hear from some other friends that your group is debating whether to add you back or not. Imagine the emotional turmoil, loneliness, and uncertainty. This is a sad tale that did happen to someone. Except here, the group chat is actually the solar system. And the sad, wronged friend is Pluto. In 2006, when the International Astronomy Union downgraded Pluto's status to that of a dwarf planet, the internet was flooded with memes. Pluto went through a range of emotions, from anger to sadness. And all the seven stages of grief. Everyone knows that life needs water. Heck, you and I exist today, and are burdened by life's demands, because some random fish, some millions of years ago decided to try walking on land. That overambitious, little moron. What I'm trying to tell you, is life cannot exist without water. While it doesn't go the other way around, there's no denying the possibility that where there's water, there's a remote chance that we might just find life. Back to my guy Pluto. Ah, little Pluto. It made a comeback, and how? When New Horizons reached the dwarf planet, the spacecraft was moving at 52,000 kilometers per hour. That's almost 13 times the fastest speed record set by DC's Flash. Yet, it showed us that Pluto was a world much more dynamic than we knew. A scientific, untouched wonderland, full of icy volcanoes, acute heart-shaped feature, and possibly underground oceans. And, at that speed, the spacecraft was able to capture close-ups of only one side of Pluto, the hemisphere that was illuminated by the sun's light at the time. The other was, for the moment, shrouded in darkness. Now that scientists have scrutinized those near-side close-ups, they are beginning to analyze the other half, which the spacecraft photographed days before it shot past. Researchers call that hemisphere the far side, or to keep things a little more interesting, the dark side. No, not dark sight. Although the images aren't as clear as those taken later, they still reveal Pluto's terrain clearly. At best, the images are 250 times better than the pictures shot by the Earth-orbiting Hubble Space Telescope, and that's something. It's a ton of juicy data, about a planet that lies in the Kuiper Belt, of which we knew almost nothing, at one point of time. And, it's the best we can do until another spacecraft visits the dwarf planet. Now, with hundreds of images and lots of data to analyze, scientists have a new view of this active world, one that provides important insight into how it was formed, whether there's an underground ocean hiding beneath its icy crust, and why Pluto's materials sculpt its surface like skyscrapers in a city. The data also supports the argument that the chilly world just might be fit for life. And that's a big mite, I should warn you, lest you start packing your bags and tweeting at Elon Musk. In 1996, the Hubble Space Telescope helped scientists to finally see surface details of Pluto. Although the images were fuzzy, they revealed a world that had more large-scale color contrast than any other in the solar system, except for one, Earth. It was a tantalizing, visual hint that suggested that there was more to Pluto than we knew, and this was soon verified in July 2015, when New Horizons famously spotted a heart-shaped feature just north of the near side's equator. You know that feeling when you see a dog or a cat with a heart shaped somewhere on its fur. That is adorable, isn't it? That's how I feel about Pluto. Cute little planet. Well, within the heart's left ventricle is Sputnik Planitia, an icy basin, gurgling and flowing with massive glaciers, that scientists now know has an extraordinary influence over Pluto's activity. As sunlight warms the frozen plain, a pulse of ice turns into vapor that wafts upwards, before dropping back down at the end of the day. Magical. The idea of a subsurface ocean has existed for some time, but the farside images, along with the moon's role in it, have helped to bolster this idea. Some of the strongest evidence comes from the chaotic terrain, a muddled mess of ridges, cracks, and plains on the exact opposite side of Pluto from Sputnik Planitia. Images of the dark side of Pluto show a giant crack, somewhat like a rift that has opened up, like the rift from Stranger Things, that stretches up the near side of Pluto. This can only mean one thing. Vecna is underwater on Pluto. Okay, but jokes aside, the rift now seems to run across the North Pole and back down towards the South Pole on the far side, thus wrapping around the entire dwarf planet in its embrace. The rift is probably a scar from the freezing and ever-expanding underground ocean. If true, the ocean might even be favorable for life. And here's where things get extremely interesting. The water that gushed out of the ocean on the near side was red in color. This can mean one of two things. Either this is the start of a horror flick, with blood-stained water seeping out of cracks, or the water contains organic molecules. It's mostly the latter. So, organic stuff. Laboratory experiments have shown that radiation from cosmic rays can create organic matter that is reddish-brown. And if ammonia is present, then hallelujah. With ammonia, it is possible to form molecules that are crucial for life, including those present in RNA and DNAs. The theory has gained a lot of clout among planetary scientists, but not because it means that there's life on Pluto. Scientists are jumping in joy because this suggests that if life were introduced to Pluto, it might just survive. And that's a goddamn awesome revelation. Apart from helping to explore Pluto's potential for life, the farside images have also generated a number of other mysteries. But we will explore those another day. For now, all you need to know is that we are equipped with cutting-edge technology, aka the James Webb Space Telescope. Fresh off of its success with the initial batch of images, it will be directed towards the dwarf planet too. Webb, with its longer wavelengths and infrared technology, is likely to reveal something new and demystify Pluto, but what do I know? Beyond the blue.